Hello everyone, we'll talk about multistage group testing algorithms. So let's start from the introduction. So consider the following problem. Say that we are given a set of t coins, which are numbered by the numbers from 1 to t, and some of these coins are fake, and we denote the set of fake coins by s unknown. And we know that the cardinality of this set is equal to s, some constant. Our goal is to find all fake coins using the minimum number of special tests. One test is just a subset of coins, and the test result is positive if there is at least one fake coin in our test, and otherwise the answer is negative. For example, in this picture we have 14 coins, five of which are fake. They are painted with red color. We can test, for example, these three coins. All of them are good, so the test result is negative, zero. And for this test, we have one fake coin in our test, so the test result is positive. We want to use the minimum number of such tests to find all fake coins. We can consider different types of search algorithms. First type is adaptive or sequential algorithms, where later tests can depend on the results of previous tests. So for example, we can do some tests, then observe the results and decide which coins to test next. Second type of algorithms is non-adaptive or parallel algorithms, where all tests must be predefined. And the advantage of such scheme is that all these tests can be carried out in parallel, which is much faster. And we can also consider multi-stage algorithms, which consists of several stages. The number of stages is usually small, and tests inside one stage are independent from each other, but they can depend on the results of the test from previous stages. And we introduce the quantity NP of T and S, the minimum number of tests in an algorithm which can find S defects or fake coins among T coins using P stages. So what is known? We consider the case when S is some fixed constant and the number of coins, the total number of coins is big. For adaptive algorithms, it is known that the number of tests is equivalent to the S times binary logarithm of T, and it is a simple result. You can just use binary search S times to find all the coins. But for non-adaptive algorithms, it is known that the number of tests is S false in this formula. And you can see that there is a gap between lower and upper bound, the logarithmic on S. And you also can see that the number of tests is roughly quadratic on S, which is bigger than, in contrast to the linear dependency in the case of the adaptive algorithms. So you can see that for adaptive algorithms, we need less tests, much, but non-adaptive can be performed in parallel. And for many applications, it is much easier to perform a lot of tests in parallel. But we can also consider two-stage algorithms or multi-stage algorithms. And for two-stage algorithms, it is already known that the number of tests is also linear on S. We have some constant, which is obviously greater than one here, C, but the number of tests is linear, and it is very good for applications because we can perform almost all tests in parallel, but we need only slightly more tests than for adaptive algorithm. But what about this constant? The question I want to ask, can we achieve the same number of tests as in adaptive case using only a small number of stages? Not necessarily two stages, maybe three or four, but some small number. And there is a conjecture then for any fixed number s, there exists the number of stages p of s such that the number of tests is equivalent to s times binary logarithm of t. So it's roughly the same as in the fully adaptive case. And this conjecture is true for s equals 2, 3, and 4. For two coins, we need two stages. And for three and four coins, we need four stages. And it is unknown if it is true or not for s greater than 4. And we will discuss this result later in this talk. So now I will describe a hypergraph approach to this problem. We can consider the following problem on hypergraph. Assume that we are given some hypergraph H, and one edge of this hypergraph is defective. And we want to find this edge using the minimum number of questions. And the question is just a subset of vertices. The answer to the question is positive if defective edge has non-zero intersection with this subset. So you can see it is very similar to the coins problem. And indeed, a search problem for complete S uniform hypergraph on T vertices is just the same problem as the problem for T coins, S of which are fake. And we will use this language of hypergraph to solve the problem for coins. Any non-adaptive algorithm can be described with the help of matrix of tests. So let's say we have n tests and t objects. We can represent such non-adaptive algorithm as an n times t matrix. Each row of this matrix corresponds to some test, and each column of matrix corresponds to some element. And we put one into the intersection of row and column if the corresponding element is included in the corresponding test. Here in this example, we have four objects and four tests, and we have such matrix. And we can define a vector R of X and S for any subset S as a union of columns whose indexes are from S. Then outcome vector of our non-adaptive algorithm can be described as this quantity R of X S unknown, where S unknown is a set of fake coins. So in this example, we can see that we have two fake coins, coin number one and number two. So the outcome vector is just a union of the first and the second column. We will use this notation later. So assume that we're given a S uniform hypergraph and we want to find the defective hyperedge of this hypergraph. And also assume that we have already performed some tests which are described by the matrix X. We construct a new hypergraph H prime with the same vertex set, and we include into the set of hyperedges only those hyperedges of the original hypergraph which are consistent with tests from matrix X. Formally, it means that we include such hypergraphs, such hyperedges E of size S, such that R of X E unknown equals to R of X E. So again, let's consider this example. Say that we had original hypergraph. We have S equals 2, so we have just a simple graph, and it is just a complete graph on four vertices. And then a new hypergraph H prime will look like this, because the union of the first and the second column gives this vector, outcome vector R, the union of the first and the third, and the union of the first and the second, the second and the third are also can also give the same outcome vector. And we can say, for example, that coin number four can be fake because it can give this outcome vector. So now we describe how we solve problem for the case s equals 2. We want to prove the following theorem, that there exists a two-stage algorithm which finds two defective coins using two binary logarithms of t tests. And it is known that for two coins, it is impossible to find them with two logarithms of t tests with non-adaptive algorithms. Also, we can say that there exists a three-stage algorithm which finds a defective edge in an arbitrary graph using optimal number of tests. So it uses a binary logarithm of the number of edges tests, which is clearly optimal because of some information theoretic arguments, for example. So for arbitrary graph, we have three stage instead of two stages for complete graph. Okay, so how do we prove? So here is the description of our approach. We want to construct such a matrix X for the first stage that for every possible outcome vector Y, a graph H of XY contains at most D edges. And D is some small number. D is small O of N. We use this matrix as a testing matrix for the first stage. And then we will have only at most 2D suspicious coins. We can test them individually, and it is, as D is small number, it doesn't matter. So we need to construct such matrix having roughly two binary logarithms of T rows. We construct such matrix that graph H doesn't have a matching of size L or a vertex of degree L for every possible outcome vector for some L. There is an obvious observation that if the maximum vertex degree and the maximum cardinality of a matching in a graph doesn't exceed L, then we can say that the total number of edges in this graph is at most 2L squared. Let's prove it. So we can consider any maximum matching in the graph. And then we know that every edge E has at least one endpoint among the vertices of this matching. There are at most 2L vertices in this matching, and the degree of each vertex is at most L. So we have at most 2L squared edges. And we can prove that matrix X with the desired properties exists, and the number of rows of such matrix is equal to, well, this number, which is written here. And if L is growing, then we can say that it is equivalent to the two binary logarithms of T. So this is the solution for S equals 2. Let's discuss cases S equals 3 and 4. First of all, we can try to do something similar. Let's define the following configuration of L edges. We will call the set of edges SKL configuration if every two edges intersects in the same set U, and the cardinality of the set is equal to K. So we have this picture. This picture, every edge is this K vertices from the center and S minus K additional vertices. And we can prove the similar proposition that some S uniform hypergraph doesn't contain such configurations, SKL, for all K from 0 to S minus 1. Then the total number of edges in such hypergraph is at most S factorial L to the power of S. So it is independent of T, of the number of vertices, which is good. But if you want to construct a matrix X such that for any possible outcome vector Y, it doesn't have such configuration, you need more than S logarithm T test for the first stage. And actually, the problem is with configuration with big K. We can't exclude configuration with K greater than S divided by 2. So we can fix this situation for S equals 3 and 4. We just, for example, for S equals 3, we can't exclude configurations of type 3 to L. But we can exclude configurations 3, 1, L. So we exclude them. And for the case S equals 4, we exclude configuration of type 4, 1L and 4, 2L. And then we can prove that in a hypergraph H can be colored in polynomial of L number of colors in such a way that there are no two vertices of the same color in one edge. And if we can take L to be equal log T, then this number is small enough for us to finish the algorithm optimally. And so at the second stage, we can find colors of defective vertices just by testing all vertices of one color if one tests. Then we can implement some procedure to estimate degrees. I mean some details. So here, of course, and the third stage, we can find one defective edges inside one color using the binary search. And in the last stage, we can find two remaining vertices for S equals 3 and three remaining vertices for S equals 4. So this is basically the scheme of the algorithm for S equals 3 and 4. And if we choose the matrix X carefully, this algorithm gives an optimal answer. But this scheme has some problems in general case. Well, there are lots of problems, but the first one, for example, that this lemma is incorrect for S greater than 4. So the problem for S greater than 4 is open. So to conclude, we proved the conjecture for cases S equals 4, 3, and 4. And also we developed a three-stage optimal algorithm to find the defective edge in an arbitrary graph. And there are natural future research directions. First one is to prove this conjecture for S greater than 4. And we can also try to design an optimal multistage algorithm to find the defective hyperedge in an arbitrary hypergraph. So for now, we have done it only for arbitrary graph. So that's all that I wanted to tell you. Thank you for your attention.
Okay, thank you, Ilya. Do we have questions?
I see the question in the chat. What if we have a bound on the number of tests for each stage? And we want to minimize number of stages. So naturally, we want to minimize the number. No, of course, it would be nice if we have a bound for number of stages for number of tests for two-stage algorithm, for three-stage algorithm, and so on. But for now, we have non-trivial bound for non-adaptive algorithms. The lower bounds. And we have some algorithms for two-stage, four stages. We have some specific algorithms for the number of stages. So, for example, I don't know if it is possible to find, I don't know any non-trivial bound for two-stage algorithm and three coins, lower bound. Maybe it is possible to find them three coins using only two stages. I don't know. The other question, is it possible that P of S is S? Well, yeah, it's possible. So now we know only that P of 2 is 2, and P of 3 and P of 4 is at most 4. So yes, it's possible.